Emmanuel Opio, Lira District by statistician, says the major cause of teenage pregnancies is abject poverty and poor parenting. He says incest has become very rampant in the region, with a boy recently impregnating his three biological sisters. Opoka says COVID-19 worsened the situation and Lango was among the most affected regions.
34% of young women between 20 and 24 old were either married or in a union before the age of 18. 17% were married before the age of 15. Unfortunately, the COVID-19 pandemic appears to have worsened the situation, with Lango being one of the worst hit by the virus with 23,000 teen pregnancies. Indeed, data taken during and after the COVID-19 lockdown suggested that Uganda may be in throes of a war far crisis with the longer term social and cultural implications for the nation.
Patrick Abao, a clan leader, says the Lango Cultural Institution is trying its best to curtail child marriages. Abao called for implementation of the Child Act 2019. He says the cultural institution is being blamed for not acting, yet it is the implementers of the law that are sleeping on the job.
So we have cooperating among committee members. There, first of all, even the relatives, they don't know themselves. Relatives marrying a fellow relative. He has been very common and have witnesses around him. Then find inadequate support from cultural leaders, political leaders, religious leaders. For this community, especially young girls, to embrace reproductive health services, we say it would spoil these young girls. But whether you give it to them or not, they will still go.
Reverend Priska Alice Auma says many girls in her home area of Omito in Lira City West Division have dropped out of school due to poverty. Auma says boys should also be empowered.
We are not dissecting this feminism. What impact does it create? We are struggling in churches because we have mothers who end up finding good men who marry them. But because they're educated and they have jobs, in their mind they think they're independent and they can lead their lives. Why are we moving away from the reality? We will come, and trust me, these programs will always be funded and funded and funded, and nothing will change.
Tom Okare, the DEO of Kole District, says leaders should accept there is a problem and speak about it instead of apportioning blame.
The most important thing is that we have to accept that there is a problem. That is the baseline. We have to accept that there is a problem. And indeed, there is a problem. As leaders, we need to speak about it. When there is a problem, we have to speak about it. We don't have to keep quiet. Our future is the children. And we are the one that gives them the direction, where to go, and what is ahead of them. But now, what we need to move away from is, let us not be putting the blame. We are all responsible. Schools have been blamed. Teachers have been blamed for doing little. And I think here I will also respond about the sexuality education.
Story by Hudson Apunyo for the news.